Danny Blondin, founder and organizer of the Belgian Project. Danny, what is the Belgian Project?
Well, the Belgian Project is something that I started up 3 years ago, 4 years ago actually, in 2008, after somebody asked me, my brother-in-law, Cormac McCann, said, do something with your contacts. And also to get our riders here from Northern Ireland somewhere a bit of advice and experience in bigger races, and also to get on an even keel when they actually get to the continent. So I thought something up. I had a team in Belgium who said to me, well, we would give you a hand with putting them down, get a few guest parents to look after the lads, get them in a guest team and let them have a bit of an experience of what really Belgium racing is about. These lads, like Simon Williams and a few more, Peter Hawkins to start with, Conor McAllister, they all came back to Ireland and done very good results after because they had a bit of a good experience over there. Okay. So it works in a way. We had a few minor ones because it's a hell of a difference between Northern Ireland racing and continent racing, but at least we can sort of see who is able to do so.
It's all about giving up-and-coming riders from here an opportunity to go to Belgium and experience racing at a higher level.
Yes, yes, that's the whole idea about it.
And how has, you said it was established in around 2008. How has it been?
One of my first graduate, Peter Hawkins. I'm quite proud of that wee lad. He's not wee anymore, but he actually took it like a fish to water. Is now one of the main lads in the Coq Sportif who just won the Belgium Cup as well and won 30 races this year. So he's in a quite big amateur team who probably gonna maybe step up next year to a higher level because they have now the riders to do so. We're not sure if Peter will stay, but that's still, we'll know next year. But Peter is one of the main ones. We have a few lads as well who Philip Bremner who done quite well there, Stuart Henry who was in the Lotto team of Minnen who done quite well and his results afterwards were great here again. So this year we had a wee young lad from Ballymena, Matthew Brennan, who was taken by a team in Ostend. And Matthew had trouble with maybe following the race in the beginning, but he established himself a bit in the end. And he maybe done not big results, but he got a hell of a lot of experience, what probably will help him next year over here, you know, so we're so, doing well.
Right, yeah. So even just since 2008, there's quite a few riders have gone out, yes, as you've described there, and they're riding at a high level. As you said, Peter Hawkins was with the team, which one of the best cycling teams in Belgium,
yes,
and Stuart Henry and some of those other riders.
Yes, yes. Yeah.
So, good progress so far. Are there any particular riders from here who you plan to send out over the next few months?
Yes, well, here and being in the cyclocross area of Lurgan here, there is a lad here, Matthew Adair, who is now junior champion of Ireland. There is a very good chance, a 90% chance, that he will be having a guest family and a guest ride in Belgium for a few weeks to let them see what it is actually like against the big boys, you know. So hopefully he does well there, but there is a bit of interest for him, so if anybody watches this, he's available.
You know. When would he be going out?
It would be sort of December, beginning January, you know, for a few weeks while he's off school, you know. So
just in a couple of months' time?
Yes, it will be in a couple of months' time, yeah. That will be all. You can follow that on the website as well, you know, what's going to happen with him. And next year, for first time, the Belgian Project will take a lady on. Excellent. We didn't really have the ladies to send, but now there's a wee girl comes up, Kiara Mulholland. She come to age as well, she's 18, so there's a good chance we're going to send her to Belgium and let her have a guest ride for a month and see how she does over there with the big girls as such, you know, so promising times ahead.
Excellent, looking forward then. What's the plans for the Belgian Project over the next few years?
Well, I would like to establish as much contacts if I can, because I worked with one team as guest team, now I have made that a bit broader, so there's other teams who get a bit interest. Of course, in Belgium, nothing is for nothing anymore. The sun doesn't go up for nothing anymore there because there's too many quests because everybody in the world want to race in Belgium. I have to pull in a lot of favors to get Northern Ireland riders there, you know, because the level of racing here is, of course, much lower. But it seems like a few teams still do me a wee favor, and with small money, we can still get a lad there for around £500 a month, everything included with flights and whatever, we can get a lot there for a month over there. Well, it's not still, because some Americans pay £2,000-£4,000 to get the same thing, so we're quite privileged that they still like the Irish lads to come down there. This is more because of their behavior as well, because they are very particular about behavior, because it's the sponsor's name or on the chest, they have to behave. And our lads here are really ambassadors for cycling sport, especially here, you know. So this is sort of a must. Therefore, I'm looking always for sponsors. This money is going straight to the running cost, because it costs a few pounds to run a project like that. To also to visit Belgium myself. Now, this is the only money I spend really on myself, to go there and make appointment, because emailing and texting doesn't work. You have to see people in person, you know, to get some results, you know. This has worked very well. I've just been back and I got already through the project as well. A Belgian team who are going to come over next year to the Tour of the North, not the Coq Sportive anymore, but a bigger team from Antwerp called Bianchi Lotto, a satellite team from Lotto. And they will make so much PR for my project that it will be easier then to get in contact with people who maybe say, we'll give it a go as well, you know. So, so I just hope that, but that costs a few pounds. I have some, you can get info in my Belgian project website on the Facebook if you need more info, how it works, what you can get. But it's basically, I'm doing 70 events a year, cyclocross, off-road, road racing, time trials. My car gets seen, advertising on the car, on my website. It gets seen by 1,000 people every week. So it's a good way of advertising, you know. So,
so you want to continue the project, you want to continue sending riders, more and more riders from here to Belgium to give them the opportunity to progress. And of course, as you say, you need funding for that, and there are opportunities.
Also, the Belgian project is also an intermediate. Like now I have a Scottish rider that I'm going to put in Belgium, but this is not at my cost, but I just make the contacts. You know, people phone now, even from Chile, people ask, could you get us in Belgium? But this is my preferably is riders from Cycling Ulster, because this is to give us a good chance. But I am an intermediate as well for people if they want to, you know. So
what's the website?
The website is www.facebook.com as normal, then you slash it, we slash, and then the Belgian project, you know, you find all information there, you know. So I just would like to mention and thank as well the authors of Recycled Memories, a brainchild of Rap Collins, May Farrer, Billy Kirk, and Isabel Woods. The profits have been shared by three projects, the Orange Field track here in Belfast, also the hand cycling of Newry, and the Belgian project have been chosen as well. That gave me a wee boost, and also to pay back the debts that I had this year and make me completely start on an even keel. So the Belgian project will be there in 2012 and hopefully 2013 as well. And maybe one day, what would repay me completely, all the work that I put in and my wife put in, would be just to see one Northern Ireland lad on some world podium somewhere in a big race, you know. And I'll be the happiest man in the world.
Keep up the good work.
Thank you very much. Bye.